Good morning students. So today recipe, that is the minestrone soup, that is the Italian soup. This soup is a thick category soup, broth soup, under the category of thick broth soup. So this soup is a represent of the Italian national. So that is a very famous soup of Italian country, and in which we are using a seasonal vegetable basically. So first I want to show you the ingredients which are required of making a minestrone soup. So the minestrone is a thick soup of Italian origin made with a seasonal vegetable. We can use a seasonal vegetable for making of this kind of soup, and often with the additional of pasta, and the sometime we can use in broth the commonly ingredients including this is the celery. The next ingredients is onion, a zucchini, beans. We can use a seasonal vegetable, I already told you that. Tomato, carrots, chopped garlic, tomato puree, that is optional. If you are not using a tomato, so you can use tomato puree, but we are using both tomato and tomato puree in this recipe. So by adding of tomato puree, the nice color of this soup. And the rest ingredients is pasta, that is a boiled kidney bean. So guys, in this recipe we can separate boil the beans because it will take a long time. That's why we will boil the separate of beans, because it will take approximately 1 or 2 hours. So that's why we will already boil the kidney beans. And the rest of ingredients, fresh basil, we can use a fresh basil leaves. The garnish for Parmesan cheese, and the seasoning, a white pepper powder. If you're not having a white pepper powder, so you can use a black pepper powder, guys. Salt as per the taste, and oil, and the last we use a vegetable stock, either you can use a non-vegetable stock. So guys, I already prepared the stock in this recipe. We can use in vegetable stock, I already prepared with the helping of onion, carrot, celery and bouquet garni. You already learned in the first semester. So these are the ingredients which are required of making of the minestrone soup. So let's start all the further process. So first we need this type of saucepan. Now I'm gonna add oil. First I'm gonna add oil into the pan. So first heat the oil into the pan. So now the oil is getting hot. So now I'm going to add garlic. And mix well with the helping of spatula. So we just cook the garlic. Bas reduce the moisture of the garlic. Do not burn extra of the garlic, because this is not Indian tadka. So now the garlic is a proper cook. So now the timing is adding for onion.
And we also cook together onion and garlic. We just translate of onion to no texture burn. Remember this point, guys. Whenever we cooking for the continental, so we just cook reduce the moisture of the garlic. Do not extra burn. Do not burn the garlic and onion. And stir continuously with the helping of spatula. So make sure you continuously stir with the helping of spatula. Do not extra burn, guys. So why the traditionally the minestrone soup is made by a leftover vegetable. You can use a seasonal vegetable. I already told you that. So I use in this recipe beans, carrots, tomato, zucchini. You also use more vegetable. And in this recipe we can use canned bean, macaroni, pasta and parmesan cheese for garnish. So the minestrone soup, the garnish with the parmesan cheese, that is a very dry hard cheese. So guys, I already told you that the minestrone, that is the thick soup of Italian region made with the seasonal vegetable. Often we can use pasta and kidney beans, including beans, onion, celery, carrot and also stock. So now you can see our onion and garlic is a proper cook. So now the timing is adding for carrots. Mix well. So we cook just carrot off when the carrots are caramelized. Do not extra burn. That is the category of the broth soup. This soup is a represent of the Italian. This soup is a represent of the Italian national, that is the Italian soup, the minestrone. So now the timing adding for tomato. Now the timing for adding tomato. We just cook the tomato when the tomato is tenderized. Do not extra burn. So now the timing is adding for beans. So also we cook the beans when the beans is a proper tenderize. And make sure you continuously stir with the helping of wooden spatula. You can see the nice color of combination of vegetables, the green, yellows and white color. We can use in the seasonal vegetable in this recipe. So now the timing is adding for zucchini. You can see guys the nice color of the vegetable combination. And I continuously stir with the helping of wooden spatula. You can stir continuously. So now the timing is adding for celery. By adding of celery, good fragments of this soup, you can use a celery stem. Against here. You can see the nice color and the nice combination of vegetable. The almost is veggies is a proper tenderize. You can cook properly guys, do not raw your vegetable, make sure your vegetable is proper cooked. If your vegetable is raw, so your soup taste is not good. Make sure your all vegetables tenderize, so that enhance the flavor of this soup. So now the timing is adding for tomato puree. You can use a little bit tomato puree in this recipe. By adding tomato puree, this soup will change the color, the offering. Now mix well. Make sure guys you continuously stir with the helping of wooden spatula. You can use ladle. So you can see the nice color of the whole vegetable. So now the timing is adding for kidney beans. I already boiled the kidney beans because it will take a long time. That's why we already boiled the kidney beans. Either you can use beans kidney, that is the canned bean. You can use canned bean instead of the kidney beans. Mix well. Because the kidney bean, it will take a 1 or 2 hour. You already know the boiling timing of the kidney beans, it will take a 1 or 2 hour. That's why we will already boil the kidney beans. mix well, all mixture. So now the timing is adding for the vegetable stock. Whether you can use chicken stock, mutton stock, but in this recipe we can use vegetable stock already prepared. So now the timing is adding for vegetable stock. And mix. So the finally I'm going to add the flavoring agents, that is a fresh basil. So why adding the fresh basil? They enhance the value of this soup. So now I use basil leaves in this soup. Now I crush the basil leaves. Do not chop. We just roughly cut by your hand and you can put. Stir well. So we will cook this mixture until the first boil. So now I'm going to add seasoning, salt as per the taste. White pepper powder, approximate is 10 gram, and mix well. So you can see that is a nice color of this soup, that is the off red color and the good fragrance by adding of the fresh basil. So now the timing is adding for pasta. And mix well. So guys, you can also use a boiled pasta, but we do not boil the pasta before. I already boiled the pasta inside of this soup, so that your soup is thickened by adding of pasta. You know very well, na? The inside of the pasta is a starch. So we do not add any kind of the thickening agent of this soup. By adding of pasta, this soup is becoming some amount of thickened due to the starch of inside of the pasta. That's why we will boil the pasta in this soup directly. Because some people is use the pasta is separate boil, but we do not boil the separate pasta. That is the thick and broth soup. This soup is the chunks inside of the stove. So now you can see that is a very nice color, nice combination of vegetable. So we will cook just first while. So now guys, you can see the small bubbling is start. So now the approximate is our soup is a proper cook. We just few minutes wait and after that switch off the gas. Now the guys, the approximate is our soup is proper cooked. We just first boil. So you can see now the bubbling is start. So now switch off the gas. Now switch off the gas. So now you can see approximate soup is cooked. Nice color. So now the timing is plating. Timing is presentation of minestrone soup. The garnish with the fresh basil leaves. And also we can use parmesan cheese on the top of this soup. So this is the minestrone soup. You can see the presentation of minestrone soup. So thank you so much guys, and you can serve hot.